In this video, I will show how to use linear transformations to graph a logarithmic function. So first, before we get started, let's take a look at the function and let's rewrite it in such a way that we can recognize all the transformations. So now the function is written in this form, so I can clearly see what each transformation means. So plus 2 on the inside means we're going to shift the graph to the left, and plus 3 on the outside means we're going to bring the graph up by 3 units. The parent function here is logarithm of x base 2, and the graph of the parent function looks like this. At 1 it is 0, at 2 it is 1, at 4 it is 2, at 1 half it's negative 1, and so on. And we'd have a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. So this is the graph of the parent function, and I'm going to apply all transformations one by one. Usually we would start with compression or stretch, but here we don't have any, so we go and jump right into shifting. I'm going to shift this function 2 units to the left and 3 units up at the same time, so every point that I have, I will move 2 units to the left and 3 units up, starting with this point. 2 units to the left, 3 units up. Now, the effect of such transformations on the vertical asymptote is the vertical asymptote will now be shifted 2 units to the left. So the vertical asymptote for the desired function is actually x equals negative 2. And continuing with my shifts, so every point that I have is shifted now 2 units to the left and 3 units up. So this is what the graph of this logarithmic function looks like after all the linear transformations are applied. I'm just going to make it more visible here. So this is the result.